And the same goes for those stupid show dogs, poodles and such, you know, complete egomaniacs, just like they're humans.
Oh, boy.
Hello, my friend. So, what's the best dog breed? Are all breeds born equal? How can some dog breeds sniff out cancer when some can't even catch a ball? And why do some dog breeds have eyes that pop out? And also, can a dog be a hypocritical breedist? Let's find out, shall we? But welcome, my friend, it's the Real Dog Show!
So, we'll be using the F to S tier listing made popular by iDubbbz. And the first breed up for review is...
Shiba Inu! If you wanted a cat, then it's okay just to get a cat, you know? I mean, you could get something that has the potential to detect cancer and everything, but yeah, just, you know, get whatever you like. But, as I said in the previous video, they are pretty okay, you know, but in small doses. You know, Shibas are cool. A dog is a dog. B. Next dog. The Golden Retriever. The Sweden of dog breeds.
That's a bit harsh in, like, so many ways.
Have you ever met one?
Well, yeah, but...
And you know how they grovel and worship the ground you've stepped on?
Well, dogs in general, in my...
It's so unsettling! Stop being so pathetic! What would our ancestors say? And also, you can smell them like two towns away. But I guess they aren't too annoying, and, you know, it's fun to play with them, so...
So, different dog breeds smell different to other dogs, right?
Well, yeah.
So you can just and instantly tell that, oh, that's a Shih Tzu and that's a Labrador and...
Or we can just, like, you know, look at him.
But some dogs have bad eyesight, am I right?
The short snout ones, yeah, a little, but it's nothing you can't live with. Unless you're like a chow chow or something like that, you know, fur getting in the way and, you know, that. Also, they're super hard to read and understand. Really unpredictable, in my opinion. Nearly bit off my face once. Can't stand the cold at all. Like, seriously. Into the E you go. Next dog. The Shetland Sheepdog. Ooh, look at me. I'm a movie star. Enviable fur, I admit. Good eyesight, too. They are a bit racist, though.
Racist? Meaning what, exactly?
Meaning that they... only kind of tolerate their own kind.
I think a breedist would be a more fitting term in this case.
Well, breedist, racist, you know, whatever. Not all of them, of course, just, you know, some of them. I know one, and he's pretty laid back and chill in general, but, you know, you can't really leave him alone with your stuff.
Okay.
Or you can, if you want your stuff to be torn into tiny little microscopic pieces. Plus, they shed like crazy. The Shetland Sheepdog can shit down in the tier she. Next dog, the Shar-Pei. Shar-Pei, more like Shar-Pee. Yeah, I mean, get it, that can be two things, depending if you're looking at it phonetically or...
Yeah. Very clever, very, very witty.
Thank you. B, next dog, the Finnish Spitz. Here's my impression of a Finnish Spitz.
Aren't you exaggerating? Just
they don't even say anything. It's just like you going, hey, 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 you, hey, hey. What? They are pretty cool because they get to hunt bears and do all kinds of other cool crap. Too bad they can't shut up about it. A solid B. No, wait, A. A, definitely A. I feel like I'm being too harsh. Am I being too harsh?
No, well, what I'm worried about is that this is going online and, you know, you might get in trouble down the line. You know, YouTuber apologies and everything, you know.
Nah, it'll be fine. Next dog, the Rottweiler. S tier. Please don't hurt me. Next dog. The Doberman, also better. So the Doberman is definitely S tier. The Rottweiler is now A, sorry, because they're more like the enforcers, whereas the Dobermans are the
top. What on earth are you talking about?
I mean, nothing. A Doberman best. We're cool, right? Next dog, the Labrador Retriever. A bit like the Golden Retriever, but better at being a proper dog. B, the Bloodhound. Now these guys are legendary.
So these are the ones that have like a really good sense of smell, right?
They're the 1% of 1% amongst us dogs.
That sounds just crazy.
Yeah, but they are a bit aloof though and really hard to establish communications with. But they are so much deeper in the world of smells than your average dog, so I can't really blame them. Also, huge and clumsy. But still, A stands for these autistic sniff sacks perfectly. Next dog, the Great Dane. One word. C tier. Next dog, the Pembroke Welsh Corgi. The stuck-up blue bloods. Like most royals, loud and obnoxious. Hobbies include shedding, being noisy, shedding, being stubborn, shedding, and tidelivitis.
You got anything positive to say about them?
Being annoyingly photogenic. I mean, the bitches are mesmerizing. S tier.
Just for the cute girl dogs?
They're called bitches. But okay, all things considered, A plus. Okay, fine. C, next dog. The German Shepherd, known for being great service dogs due to their high prey drive. Also known for being big fat turds. I said, known for being big fat...
I moved, remember?
Yeah. But anyway, they have a tendency to be a bit intense. And also, it's like they feel no pain at all. I mean, you can just, like, beat them with a stick and they're just like, wanna play? But even though they don't know how to share and are a bit primal, I give them the ranking B, but only because they are part wolf dog and that they get to do cool stuff like action RB attack dog stuff. Pew, pew, pew. Next dog, the Border Collie. Explain one thing to me. Why on earth is it so freaking amazing when someone runs or jumps through some stupid obstacles like really athletically? Like anyone can do that. Some just want to win medals or admiration.
Well, it's interesting to watch people and dogs doing super human or super dog feats. Like it's training, dedication.
And the same goes for those stupid show dogs, poodles and such, you know, complete egomaniacs, just like they're humans.
Oh boy.
Poodles can keep their stupid prizes and prance around in the F tier. Collies, on the other hand, I am forced to place in the S tier. I know, they're amazing, and I'm just being envious. Next dog, the English Bulldog. Hello, love. Need help with backing up this lorry? Oh, blimey, my hip just came out. Fish and chips, yeah? Are you having a giggle now, Mike? Oh, bless you. Literally impossible to understand or interpret as another dog. Chill and relaxed, which is nice, but a bit slow. Hobbies include eating cardboard. D. Next dog. The French Bulldog. A lot like the English version, but smaller and with more energy, and is French. E. Next dog. Huskies and Malamutes. Now these guys are absolute super dogs. About as close to a wolf as you can get. Incomparable physical capabilities. Cool looking AF. But their dialect is super hard to understand though. I mean, they are really close to wolves genetically. And, you know, wolves don't really bark. So...
Okay, now that's really interesting.
You know, it's kind of like a human speaking ye old English, you know, today.
Okay.
But they tend to be a bit overly dramatic when it comes to life in general.
You're the one to talk.
And their eyes can see right into your soul. But in general, a super cool bunch. Definitely S tier.
Cool.
And also, have you seen the holes they can dig? It's amazing. Next dog. The Spanish Water Dog. All in all, a pretty cool bunch. Suitable for humans with allergies even for the most part. And not at all pushy. Good guys. Sometimes they may be a teeny tiny bit breedist and suspicious. But once you get to know them, they're the best friend you'll ever have.
I'm sensing some form of favoritism here.
What do you mean? Well...
You've been busting your chops to pretty much every other breed on this list. I mean, it's only fair to...
Okay, fine! Here's my impression of a Spanish water dog. Do something.
Okay, what?
Just about anything.
Okay.
It's in A tier.
did you know that you kind of look like one?
I do.
But your fur is it's a little different, though. Like, we don't actually know what breed you are yet. I mean, you are a rescue dog, so it is possible that you're a mutt.
How dare you! My father was certainly a noble gray wolf. How else would I be so good-looking and intelligent and resilient? And my mother, she must have been a beautiful, wise Akita, who didn't have the heart to eat any of her puppies. She loved us all. And also, stop using that word as a pejorative term. I mean, I have never... Hashtag, all dogs are beautiful.
You know damn well I don't mean it like that. I mean, I don't personally care what breed you are.
So now you don't care about my heritage?
I do. That's why I'm asking.
I don't know what breed I am, okay? I don't know.
Hey, buddy, come on. It's okay. It's okay. Look, you're my best friend no matter what.
And you're my trusty assistant.
What do you say if we sort your lineage out later? But we'll do it together.
Yeah! Next dog! The pug! Definitely the best dog! S-tier!
Okay, now I'm just confused.
What do you mean?
You've completely roasted most of them, and pugs you decide to leave alone.
Edgar and Maya may be watching, and I want to collab with Felix one day. So if you would please, zip it. So pugs are the best dog.
Yay!
Next dog, the Chihuahua. So here's my impression of a Chihuahua. No wonder you gotta tram them around in a handbag. But it's not like it's their fault. But on a serious note, though, we gotta talk about this breeding thing a bit more.
Like, what do you mean? Like,
the thing with the eyes? You know? Stop making us sick, goddammit!
Yeah, I know. It's pretty disgusting.
Everyone, you should really watch BBC One's Pedigree Dogs Exposed. I mean, I might do a video about it at some point, but please, take a look at it.
Yeah, for real. Watch it.
And to those humans doing the horrible, horrible things to my kind. Bad human. Bad. Now I think this might do for this episode. Way to end it on a positive note, I guess.
Plenty of dog breeds left, though. Part 2?
Definitely. And even though I slightly roasted some of you guys, you know I'm just playing with you. We like to have fun on this channel.
But just to recap, in general, all dogs have good hearing, right?
Mm-hmm. God-like. No, more like dog-like. Sublime.
And there's plenty of dogs living in this new neighborhood of ours.
Yeah, there are. This is very nice. There's this really cute water dog.
So they may have heard all the things you've said about them, like at least a block or two away, right?
Well, technically, yeah, but... Oh, crap. My name is Pato.